Hi everyone, today me and my colleague, we are going to present a workshop, Academic Anxiety. Before we will start, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Lucien Hambartsumian, and I'm a master level psychologist and group therapy coordinator. I work at counseling and psychological services here at University of Michigan-Dearborn. And Jimmy, please introduce yourself.
Hi everyone, my name is Jimmy Vong. I am the clinical social worker at the U of M CAPS. Yeah, so my job is mainly clinical therapy and case management.
Okay everyone, we are starting today and we are talking about academic anxiety, one of the conditions that most of the students experiencing when they are in college. And I think if they were experiencing this even before joining college, being in elementary school, middle school, and high school, and most of you experience this condition. We will try to understand what means academic anxiety. I wonder if you will realize that academic anxiety is some type of normal condition. Yeah, it can be extremely challenging. It can create a lot of mental tension and unpleasant condition, but it's something that everyone is experiencing. And for realizing this, I'm more than sure you don't need to have a lot of examples, because it's something that you're experiencing when you have your midterms, when you have your finals, when you have some type of projects, academic tasks that need to be done. But academic anxiety, when we're experiencing this type of condition, many students may feel apprehensive over the academic tasks. And we need to be able to identify and understand if we have fears, which type of fears we have. They are realistic, they are unfounded, unrealistic type of fears, or we have some type of mental condition or health concerns or even learning disabilities. And for students who are experiencing realistic fears, it can be something that they are not ready for their task. If, for example, if we are talking about tests, like they didn't study enough, or they feel like class that they are enrolled is more challenging than they were thinking. They also can feel like they didn't put enough effort to be ready for their test, and which in this case, it's very realistic fears, because they are scared, they are anxious that they may fail their class and they may have poor results, like their performance is not going to be as good as how they were planning. When we're talking about unfounded fears, we need to remind ourselves that it's not a realistic fear. It's something that you're creating in your mind, taking in consideration your past negative experience. For example, like you can think that your professor doesn't like you, which is not true. It's something that you're assuming. Or you may think like your parents and classmates, they don't think that you're a smart student or you have capacity, you're enough intelligent to pass this class. And you're always nervous about your performance. And sometimes you're taking your negative past experience thinking, I'm going to fail this class. I'm a failure. Like it's a very negative, pessimistic self-talk, which is not going to help you. And you need to remind, yeah, maybe last time I was not ready for my test or for my presentation or project, but this time I studied enough well, I was able to organize my time, I was very careful with my deadlines, and I didn't procrastinate, and things were going well, and I used study skills that works better for me, or I was able to get the help of tutoring services. I emailed to my professor. I was always trying to engage and see if I'm in right direction. Like you try to do everything, and which means you need to remind yourself, I feel this way, like I am anxious or I am fearful, but I did everything to be ready for my test. And this time I will be able to handle and have a better performance or better grade. We also don't need to ignore about learning disabilities. Some group of the students, they have learning disabilities, and it can be a big issue for their academic performance. If you have a learning disability or some kind of condition, let's say like you have depression or you have health issues, the best thing what you can do to contact with disability services, provide documentation and see which kind of accommodation as a students you may have. But I wonder if you will remember that academic anxiety, it's some type of condition that most of the students experiencing during their college years, and how I mentioned, not only college years. Now, we were able some way identify anxiety, academic anxiety, and how I mentioned, usually it relates to our academic tasks, and our academic tasks, they are different. It's a test anxiety, it's a projects, it's a group presentations, it's some kind of public speech that you need to give in front of your classmates or even bigger group. It's many, many things, or maybe you're participating as a senior in research or you need to write a thesis. All of those things, they can be anxiety provoking situation. But here I would like to emphasize your attention on test anxiety. And I decided nicely divide test anxiety like before test, like which kind of steps you can take to help yourself prevent or reduce academic anxiety, test anxiety, during the test, how you need to behave, and after test, what is happening with you. And before test, like all of you know, it's important thing, being prepared for your exam, which means you need to plan very well what need to be done, what you need to learn. You need to schedule your life. If you have other type of responsibilities, let's say like you're working, you have an internship, you have family responsibilities. We have many students that they have different type of responsibilities. The college is not only their main responsibility. That's why it's really good to schedule and know how you can manage your time and different type of responsibilities. And during studying, it's very important to prioritize your studying, that it's a priority number one before your test, that you will be ready. And definitely practicing, you need always practice and be ready for your test, and relaxing, which means you are not forgetting to have a breaks and help yourself, that your mind and body are not overwhelmed and you can perform really well. That's why it's very important to practice self-care. And during our workshops, like CAPS was providing multiple workshops, me and my colleagues were many, many times emphasizing the importance of self-care. It's like you need to get enough sleep and rest, be able to function well, because you know, if you don't get enough rest and sleep, it's not easy to be attentive, it's not easy to stay focused, it's not easy to function well cognitively. That's why it's very important. And even your body is not functioning well because you're always tired or you're always fatigued. Another thing, trying to have a nutritional food, food that really gives you nutrition. We have our physiological needs and we need to be able to satisfy our needs and maintain healthy lifestyle. Physical activities, like we talked and emphasized many times, how is it important to help our body to reduce stress and maintain healthy lifestyle. Drinking a water, it's very important. We need to hydrate our body. Thank you, Jimmy. It was a good reminder. I really like that. That's why, please, practice self-care. It's very, very important. Like, this need to be done before test, like, started. And I don't want, if you will study for your test like 1 day or 2 days before test, especially if you have very challenging class, you need to take your time and organize and manage your time very well, that you're studying for longer time, and when time is coming, you're ready. Now, moving to next step, like for example, when it's a test day, definitely you may be anxious during the time. But you need to remember the good thing, if you were able to have a good sleep and have a rest, you need to start your day early. You need to start, be ready for your test before the test. For example, like before when you were taking your test in classrooms, which means like being in classroom earlier, like 15 minutes earlier, 20 minutes earlier before your test. But now when everything is done online, again, being ready, finding that place where you can stay focused and you are not going to be distracted by noises or something that will take your attention, that you may stay focused. If you feel like you're anxious before you're starting your test, please remind yourself, use self-talk until I'm ready, I studied, I can handle this, and you can have a deep breathing, like helping your body to relax and your mind. You can make some movements with your shoulders, like helping to release that stress and tension of your muscles, and trying very carefully to read your questions. You don't need to rush, you need to take your time. And again, reminding yourself that you are ready and you can do this and you can have a good results. In case if you studied, again, it's very important. Reminding yourself and staying more positive and removing your negative thoughts. Sometimes students, they can tell, like they feel some kind of cognitive fog, like it's a fog, cognitive fog, and they cannot perform. Take your time, again, try to breathe until you will feel like you were able a little bit reduce that anxiety. And for many students, if they are ready for test, they feel like when they are starting to work and go from one question to next, slowly, slowly, their anxiety is getting more manageable and controllable, and it will happen with you too. And definitely the good thing when you're already done with test, you feel huge relief. But before we will move to last part, like after test condition, I want to remind you, if you feel like you easily get triggered, anxious and stressed before test and during test time, please try to reduce interaction with like other group of the students, classmates who are very nervous and anxious, because they can trigger panic anxiety and panic attack and anxiety. Please remove yourself from this type of discussions. And after, you can engage with them and talk, but not before test. It's not going to help you. And after test, congratulations, you are done with your task. Now you can take time for yourself. You can talk with your friends, you can review, but you need to remember that even after test, you need to practice everything what we talked, what you need to do before test to be ready for the big day. Now, I would like to move to another academic task, like public speaking. That many students were reporting that they are experiencing anxiety when they need to do public speaking in front of their classmates and professors. They feel like they are not enough smart. They feel like they are getting judged by others. And again, it's everything in their mind, that they cannot sound well, like they cannot show what they know. How you can help yourself to overcome this type of condition? The first thing, definitely practice. Like with practicing, it's you're feeling more natural, it's easier for you to make presentation. Important thing, you need to know your topic, which kind of presentation you are going to do. And which means you need to be very well organized. Like you need to think, okay, this is the time. It depends how long is going to be your presentation. How you can manage the time enough well that you're able to present your information clear way, understandable way, that you feel like you're managing your presentation enough well, not only for yourself, but also people who are listening to you. Practice and practice and practice. I always suggest my students, if they are telling they have a public speaking anxiety, practice like day before. Try to see how you look. You can do this in front of the mirror, or those days we have everywhere cameras. You can take your phone, you can record your voice, you can record yourself, and you will be able to see how you look, like how other people perceive you, because sometimes you may have a totally wrong perception of your own self. And you may think, oh, this is how I sound, this is how I look, this is how other people can see me. That's why practicing will help you to have better understanding how other people may perceive you and information that you are presenting. Challenge specific worries, like those worries, like how is my voice, how I sound, how is my material, like you need to challenge. Visualize your success. It's very important to be able to see yourself, have that picture that I'm successful because I'm familiar with my material. This is what I was studying, or this is that I was doing search, reading all those articles or finding this information. I knew what I'm going to present because this was my topic. I am familiar with this topic. And even if my students or my professor will have questions, I am enough well informed to be able to go through questions and give them answer. And very important, again, being able that you're ready and you're very well familiar with your material. Don't be fearful or uncomfortable with moment of silence. It's very normal because you have your thoughts, you're checking if you were able to cover all information that need to be presented, and you can have a moment of silence. That's great. Have that silence, and after you will continue. Nothing is wrong with the moment of silence. You don't need to be uncomfortable or fearful of that moment. Now, other thing you need, just a minute, I would like to see if I covered everything. Yep. And I'm moving toward other academic tasks that many students are experiencing. It's working with projects, group projects. And some students, they have a positive experience. Some students, they have very negative experience. They don't like to work with groups. They think when they are working solo, they are more successful. Sometimes they feel students that if they are responsible, other members of the groups, they like to take advantage because they are responsible. They do things really well. And some students, they are not providing enough effort for the group projects. Yeah, it can be challenging because people are different. They have a different style of work. But being able to minimize the negative experience and reduce the anxiety related to group projects, it's very important that each member of the group project will have a clear role, what they are going to do, and they will try to follow those roles. And they will, and I will talk about this. It's very important to clarify the role and expectations, which kind of expectations from every member of the group. If it's a 5 people, 6 people, 4 people or 3 people, depend on the group projects, like how many people are involved. Trying to establish deadlines and responsibilities. When, for example, let's say like every week group need to meet to discuss which part of project was done. Again, you have deadlines, you have responsibilities, and everyone tries to provide their portion of the work. And it's very important to have those regular meetings or time when everyone is able to meet, and those days things are done virtually, which means it's on a virtual level. You don't need to meet in the special place like in the library or in lab to discuss these type of things. Trying to be a team player, please don't avoid your team. Try to interact with your team. And sometimes students are experiencing social anxiety. It can be extremely challenging for them because they already feel like they cannot speak, they cannot present what they like to present. They feel like they can be judged by other more active members of group. I mean, active people who can express themselves very well, they are more actively involved, they're constantly sharing different opinions. Try to be part of your team and don't avoid your team. And very important that everyone is accountable. Like you need to know that you're a part of this team, and having that leader who can really well manage teamwork. And how I mentioned, it's creating a plan and following the plan, communicating. It's extremely important to communicate. If you're feeling frustration, if you feel like you are not able to express your opinion, like other members of group, they are not taking in consideration what you would like to share. It's very important to let them know what is going on and why you feel this way. Being honest, let's say like something happened, like you have some kind of emergency situation or urgent situation in your life, immediately contact with leader of the group and other members of group. Let them know that, for example, you're not going to participate for that meeting, or you cannot present your part and you need a little bit extension. It needs to be very honest and collaborative type of interaction with your group members. And dealing with conflicts. Unfortunately, sometimes when situation gets a little bit more complicated and some members feel like no one is taking in consideration what is going on in their life or which kind of challenges they are experiencing with their part of project, it's very important to have a help, sometimes even help of your professor who can facilitate the situation, because it's not always that people who works in the group, they are choosing their group members. Sometimes it's happening that professor is dividing students. And very important, if your professor and leader of the group, they will know what is going on and why some members are experiencing challenges. Bless you, Jimmy. This way you may get that help. And again, don't procrastinate. Any type of academic task that you have, you need to try to manage procrastination. Yeah, all of us who are human beings, we procrastinate time to time. It happens with everyone. But I don't wonder if it will be habit, because when you feel like it's becoming habit for you, you're always going to miss your deadlines. You're always going to experience extra stress, and it's not going to help you. It's even going to bring more complications in your life. I think, Jimmy, I'm done with my part and now moving to second part of our presentation.
Thank you for leading me to the procrastination part. So what is procrastination? Procrastination is avoidance of doing a task which needs to be accomplished, right? And when it comes to procrastination, oftentimes we kind of avoid doing really important tasks, really urgent tasks, which can often manifest guilty conscience, making us concerned about needing to do something. And what stems from us from procrastinating? It could stem from having self-doubt, worrying about the pressure of needing to complete something on time, potentially letting a peer member down if you're in a group project, feeling like you're not smart enough or have the ability enough to complete something on time. Therefore, we tend to divert our attention elsewhere. You know, we tend to lie to ourselves or say we can do this later, or I'll do better when I wake up in the morning. We create multiple reasons to why we procrastinate. And what we can note in academic procrastination is that it makes it worse every time you push something off, right? So avoiding something that needs to be done. And I get the idea that if an assignment is huge, I get the idea if a project is 60% of your grade, it adds a lot of pressure, which makes a person not want to think about the idea. So we tend to create multiple lists of reasonings to put that thought to the side, and I'll address that later. And what we can note with procrastination, that it can transition from next day to next day to next day to next day. And oftentimes, a lot of students will find themselves cramming and not being their best self trying to complete something. But I'm going off, not off topic, but I'm talking about other slides at the moment. So if we can move to the next slide, please.
Yes, Jimmy. Always please let me know when I need to.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. So what are some lists of things that we tell ourselves? You know, we say, I'll do this tomorrow. I can do this if I can enjoy myself later. I can, you know, if I can go out tonight with my friends, I can start the assignment tomorrow morning. And those are some examples that students typically give themselves, is that they'll tell themselves, I'll do it tomorrow, I'll do it later, or I'll do the dishes first, and then maybe I'll watch an episode of Friends or a TV show in that moment. And the next thing you know, it's 11 p.m. and they're tired and they fall asleep, and they say that cycle kind of repeats itself. Next thing students tell themselves is, you know, I need to clear my mind first, do something first, something else. Maybe I can change the course of my direction. This happens quite often with procrastination, is that they create an idea, the idea gets overwhelming, and that they say, I'll do this later when I have time. Or I can minimize my direction or redirect myself and work on something else to make it easier for myself. Or maybe I should just relax myself. These are things that we often tell ourselves when we try to procrastinate. And that makes it really, really challenging for ourselves when we are constantly giving ourselves misdirection, when we have something that's really important to do in an urgent and timely manner. And it builds up, right? So what we want to do is we want to avoid pitfall. These are constant indecision, right? Am I going to do it today? And I'll do it later. Am I going to do it tomorrow? And I'll do it the next day. We make tasks seem more difficult. Because if you're in your in your program or even whatever classes that you're taking, you know, everything is laid out for you early on with your, you know, syllabus. And the minute we wait to the day before, or the minute we wait to the week of, it makes it more difficult for you to do things in a more clear mind. You know, we work, the idea of worrying is one of those triggers for anxiety to make us put things off, right? We're afraid to tackle it head on. We make things unsure for ourselves and make it very unfamiliar for ourselves with a given task. When reality is that if we were to spend time earlier on, we can become more familiar with it. That's the most challenging part is that when the thing is, you and I, listen, and anyone else in school, we're always constantly learning, right? The idea of learning is scary. Learning an unfamiliar topic can be very challenging. So yes, the idea of unfamiliarity could definitely trigger some anxiety, making you feel like I can't do this. I'm not smart enough for this, or this is very challenging for me. Could really, really make you not want to focus on that assignment. But the reality is you have months, weeks, multiple weeks ahead of time to look at something. You can ask, I have on the next slide, not right now currently, we'll talk about different solutions and how you can overcome procrastination. But you really want to avoid the intensified feeling of having thoughts of messing up. The only reason we're going to mess up or not do things to the best of your ability is when you wait to the last minute, right? And that could really be detrimental to your performance, your grade, or even this group project. So recognizing your self-defeating behaviors, you know, things that we create for ourselves that cause a lot of fear, or recognize things that we're doing wrong, like poor time management, you know, if you could break things down to more manageable approaches. For example, I'm going to research this 3 weeks beforehand. I'm going to type up my notes for this. I'm going to review my notes for this. Recognize making decisions on certain days that you're going to follow through with this. Recognizing that not everything needs to be perfect. If it's an unfamiliar topic, we're not going to be perfect. Training yourself to accept that 98% performance rather than 100% performance. Allowing yourself to say, I'm still learning. That's why I'm in school. I'm working on myself so I can be more familiar with this topic. You know, identify your goal. What do you want to accomplish from this course? Prioritize what's important to you and recognize what's urgent to you that needs to be done right today. If something that is urgent that has to be done currently and you're misdirecting yourself, redirecting yourself by saying, I'll hang out with friends and do this later, you're doing yourself a disservice by not focusing on things that's important to you. You're telling yourself friends outweigh assignments, which happens quite often with students, or, you know, or TV, recreational TV is more important than your assignment. So we really have to practice discipline, and we really have to practice the now. And that's the one of the most challenging part is to really be in control and recognizing ways to we could do this more healthy, right? So on the next slides, we're going to talk about how we can develop study habits in regards to procrastination. And the hardest part is starting, right? So starting is very challenging. And for me, there's actually studies that has note that start with the hardest part. But for me personally, I like to start with the easiest part because for me, to get the ball rolling, I just need to do some research. Research is easy. You can go to the library, you can punch in Google, you can punch in any thesaurus, you can just search anything, right? To just familiarize yourself with the topic. And for me, I can just type it in and then next thing you know, I'm collecting data and putting things in note and organizing things. That's the most easiest part for me. For other people, they tend to do the harder part, which is just doing the assignment, see what they know currently. And that's not feasible for me. But however, everyone's different and just recognizing your own strength and how you can do things. The next thing you can do is breaking it down, you know, making it more manageable, making it, you know, week to week base. It could be partnering up your group members. It could be studying with your classmates, you know, breaking down like what section can we study together? What can we do to review together? Recognizing the environment, you know, is your home environment a distraction or is it supportive? Is it, you know, is your room a good place to study at, or is there that bed too comfortable for you to study on, you know, things like that where we kind of just throw ourselves off or give ourselves an easy pass, right? Because let's say you study for 20 minutes and you're laying in your bed, next thing you know, you passed out. And that's something that happens quite often with procrastination is that we create an environment that is kind of easy for us to escape. And next thing you know, we procrastinate by not doing things to a full ability. So it's really important to set a place and tone for how you want to study. A lot of students utilize the library because other students are studying, so that really encourages them to be in the right mindset to study. And the other students do is put in headphones and listen to classical music without lyrics. They practice not cramming last minute. They really train themselves studying weeks beforehand so that they're not doing something, practice weeks beforehand so they're not messing up. And developing a routine, you know, having healthy study habits. You know, what's one thing to help you study? A lot of students is picking up a pen or paper. And that triggers them to start writing down their notes and thoughts in their head about what they know. And then they go on from that, right? Just picking up a pencil can be an easy, healthy approach. There's nothing challenging about it. But next thing you know is that if you train your brain, we've been trained since day one, and you pick up a pencil, you write something down. If you write down some things that you were familiar with, next thing you know, you are familiar, you're reminding yourself that you're familiar with the topic, and you learn from that approach. And next thing you know, you're searching more about it and researching more about it. And setting down specific study time goals, like what do you hope to gain within this X hour study time? You know, it's good to recognize, good to know, you know, what you gain, what you're retaining, what you're learning from each time you're studying or working on an assignment. So that way you can present the information with full knowledge or just grasp the information so you can reshare with your friends. If you can reshare the information that you learn with your friends, that means you're learning things. Also reviewing notes before you go into starting assignments or sharing with your group, like we were doing before, which can really help you work on your procrastination. If you have a support group, you have friends that you can talk to, holding each other accountable and holding yourself accountable. That's the most key part is to dealing with procrastination, is that starting and holding yourself accountable. You know, that's the best way to manage it. And if you need additional support by having challenges to hold yourself accountable, you know, add people in your life that can help you manage this. Typically other classmates, because you guys both often utilize each other for support. Do we have any questions?
Let's check. I don't see. It looks like
no,
we don't.
We don't. Cool. So I want to thank everyone if you are watching this video later on, for being here. Lucy and I really appreciate you all for taking the time to watch our video. We hope that it's helpful. I do want to note that we do have other presentation during this week. So if you want to check on our website, UMDCAFS, we have it all there. Okay.
And thank you very much. And please try to practice what was presented. And remember that academic anxiety is very common condition for many students. And I really loved when Jimmy, you mentioned about it's a learning process. All of us were learning. And you need to be patient with yourself and try to start to develop those skills, like you're managing your time, you're organized, you're trying to reach out different type of services, because universities has different type of services to help students, and goal of those services to help students to be successful with their academic performance. And we wish you a great day. And stay tuned, and how Jimmy mentioned, check our website. We have different type of workshops, and you can always watch and help yourself. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye, listen.
Bye-bye, Jimmy. Bye.